السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم زدنا علما يا رب العالمين. Thank you brother Hatim, thank you مشايخنا, thank you these brothers, these faces. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless our gathering. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى make this gathering from our موازين الحسنات. إنه على كل شيء قدير. I'm so happy to be among you tonight here in Bay Area in California in San Francisco. I love this area so much. Subhanallah, I was telling people yesterday, when I come to California, especially Bay Area, I found two things. Smiles on the faces of people, subhanallah, and good weather. Always. I come in winter, in summer, in autumn, and good weather, good smiles. MashaAllah. Yani I love that, subhanallah. Today, inshallah, we're going to talk about al-maqamat in 1 hour, like what the brother says. Then after that, we're going to open questions and answers, inshallah. And we're going to also listen to some recitations and give, inshallah, some advices in about like 15 minutes, inshallah. But the total will be 1 hour and a half, bi-ibnillahi ta'ala. This hour, I would love to divide it. 15 minutes will be about al-maqamat theoretically, because al-maqamat is knowledge. And we're going to talk about it a little bit theoretically. Then inshallah, 45 minutes, we're going to talk about al-maqamat practically. I'm going to recite, I'm going to show you the styles of this inshallah knowledge. Why I have to start this lecture with the theoretical part? Because many people, they don't know even what is the meaning of maqamat. And some people, they got confused. Like, how come that? It's new knowledge? Islam يعني, has knowledges, and we know Islamic studies and knowledges. يعني, why you bring a new subject and it's new for us? What is the point behind that? I have to explain this inshallah in 15 minutes to make sure that we are not innovators. We are not innovating knowledge. This knowledge exists from hundreds of years. And we have to know this knowledge gonna help you to recite like what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reciting. That's the whole thing. We would love to recite Quran like a sahaba. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ashabihi al-kiram. They could recite al-Quran beautifully without any lineages. There is no Islamic studies in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'll give you an example now. What is the famous Islamic studies which everyone knows? Fiqh, Tawheed, Aqeedah, Hadith, Ulum al-Hadith, is that right? Ulum al-Tafsir, is that right? That's Islamic sciences. Okay, let us start one by one. Hadith. Who made the subjects, the notions of ilm al-hadith? Ulama al-hadith. Not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not the Sahaba, not tabi'in, not tabi'i al-tabi'in. In the fifth generation of al-tabi'in, al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he collected sahih al-Bukhari. Then after al-Imam al-Bukhari passed away for 100 years, a'immat mustalah al-hadith, they made the knowledge of al-hadith. Hadith, science, علم الحديث. Al-hadith al-sahih, al-hadith al-da'if, al-hadith al-hasan, a good one, the authentic one, the weak one. The Prophet did not say that. The Sahaba did not say that. They didn't talk about hadith al-sahih. The Prophet was saying a hadith in front of them. They didn't need strategies and categories. But ulama al-hadith, رحمهم الله تعالى, they made this to preserve كلام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا جزاهم الله خيرا. Yeah, we cannot say, oh, علماء الحديث are innovators. They did something the Prophet didn't do it. Yeah, they wanted that time to preserve and protect what the Prophet said. Then they do رضوان الله عليهم this knowledge. But this is the first science from the Islamic sciences. Is that right? The second one is علم التفسير. Tafsir science. Alhamdulillah, I graduated from Al-Azhar from علوم القرآن. We studied more than 20 books about علوم القرآن. الناسخ والمنسوخ, العام والخاص, المطلق والمقيد. When I give you ayah now, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله. Is this ayah is general ayah or this ayah is particular ayah? It's a specific ayah for specific people. How to know? العام والخاص. Okay, when Allah commands you something, will you make it as an obligatory act? Well, sometimes it comes as a sunnah act. For example, Allah said that make suhoor, tasahharu. That's the hadith and the ayah. وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطَ. Eat before Fajr in Ramadan. Now it's command, is that right? Eat. Okay, suhoor is wajib, obligatory act or sunnah act? Sunnah act. But the ayah comes as a order, as a command. Ah, because there are commands in the Quran, it comes in the way of sunnah. And there are commands in the Quran, it comes as a obligatory act. Like aqeemu salah, praying. Oh, prayer is obligatory act, Shaykh. But suhoor is sunnah act. But both of them comes in the way of ordering, commanding. Ah, how to differentiate without the knowledge of ilm al-Quran, ulum al-Qanawi? You cannot differentiate. Oh, if we need ulum al-Quran to understand what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how the Prophet was understanding the ayat and give it to his sahaba. We need ulum al-Quran science. We need tafsir science to understand. But actually it's helpful. It's not innovation. Yeah. Let us go to ulum. Tawheed wal-aqeedah. Who can tell me the types of al-tawheed? We have three types of al-tawheed. Who can tell me? Bismillah, Shaykh. Tawheed al-asma wal-sifat. MashaAllah alayk. Ah, did the Prophet say that? Who said that? Sahaba? No. Tabi'een? No. Ulama al-aqeedah, starting from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and other ulama. Oh, are they innovating this? No. They did this to preserve the concept of Tawheed itself. Sahaba didn't need أقسام التوحيد أقسام الله. They didn't need that. Sahaba, alhamdulillah, just the Prophet was saying something. Alhamdulillah, they understand it, they memorize it. They didn't need these sciences, but we need it. Let me go to last one, then I'm gonna hit maqamat. تجويد. تجويد. تجويد rules. المد المتصل. المد المنفصل. المد العارض للسكون. المد الكلمي المثقل. المد الكلمي المخفف. الغنة. Did the Prophet say غنة in any hadith? Show me where. He did not talk about غنة. But he was making غنة. And the Sahaba were making غنة. And they didn't need that time as science talks about غنة and مدود. But we need it now. Because we, our level, it's not like their level. We need something like this to understand. Then علماء التجويد in the 5th century after رسول الله والصحابة والتابعين. In the 5th one, Imam al-Jazari made a book of تجويد and say there is a غنة, there is a مد, there is a لحن جلي, لحن خف قلقلة, إبا إبا قلقلة. The Prophet didn't say إبا إبا. He didn't say that. Yeah. But he was doing it. Yeah. Then these ulama categorize this knowledge to make you recite like him. It's kind of helpful science. Okay. Now the science of maqamat. أيوة. How to beautify your voice like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No way to do that without ilm al-maqamat. You can do this as a natural thing. I will be fine, but it won't be like the one who study this knowledge and try to understand what's going on. His recitation definitely will be better than the one who is reciting Quran beautifully without knowing anything. Just Allah give him talent and he is reciting Quran beautifully. That's good, by the way. He's reciting like Rasulullah. Okay, that's good. But if you learn, oh, you will beautify your voice more. And I did this with يعني, Imams from Imams al-Haram. Yeah. Their recitation was amazing before. They didn't need me. But when we talk, when I teach the details, their recitations now, it's better than before. Like if their recitation was 50-70%, now they're at 90-95%. They learn a lot and they knew the details, the small details. And you're gonna see now, inshallah. This is al-maqamat science. It exists hundreds of years, and this science talk about the voice itself. What is the types of the voice? What is the tunes? How to bring the tunes? This knowledge gonna help you to beautify your voice and recite al-Quran like how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited. طيب, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in three ahadith that you have actually to beautify your voice in the Quran. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taghannu bil Quran. Hadith fi sahih al-Bukhari. Taghannu. Ya'ni beautify your voice when you recite al-Quran. It's a command from Rasulullah. Al-ulama has two opinions. The first opinion said it's obligatory act because it's command. Like aqeemu salah, taghannu bil Quran. Other ulama say, no. It's a command in the way of sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, taghannu bil Qur'an, that in the way of sunnah, like what he said, make suhoor. It's not أقام الصلاة. طب how to differentiate? That's something in fiqh now. I'm talking about fiqh issue. How do differentiate between the command which is obligatory act and the command which is sunnah act? How to differentiate? The command which comes as an obligatory act, you have to have another dalil says if you don't do it, you will be punished. So we have dalil in Al-Quran, if you don't pray, you will be punished. Oh, you are praying now, the command of praying is obligatory. Because we have another dalil says if you do not pray, you will be among disbelievers. الَّذِينَ لَا يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. Ah, now I know now, the obligatory, it's obligatory now. It's not just istihbab sunnah, la 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 la, it's obligatory. But there is no dalil says if you do not have suhoor, you will be punished. For the command of suhoor here, it comes in the way of sunnah. Same thing, تغنوا بالقرآن, beautify your voice. There is no hadith says if you do not beautify your voice, you will be punished. No hadith says this. يبقى التغني بالقرآن سنة. To beautify your voice in the Quran is sunnah act. There is another hadith, والله, it's a scary hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in البخاري, من لم يتغنى بالقرآن فليس منا. الله أكبر. شوف سكيري حديث. The one who does not beautify his voice in the Quran, he does not recite like us. Yeah. حديث في البخاري. من لم يتغنى بالقرآن. فين التغني بالقرآن؟ Beautify as much as you can. Some Sahaba, they were beautifying their voice to the best, like Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله عنه, Sahabi, companion, was reciting the Quran beautifully without knowing that the Prophet was listening to him. يعني imagine, he was reciting alone and he was beautifying his voice. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet ﷺ next day in Salat al-Fajr said, Ya Aba Musa, إني استمعت إليك البارحة. Me and my wife were listening to you yesterday and your voice was amazing. Then Abu Musa said, والله يا رسول الله لو أعلم أنك تستمع إلي البارحة لحبرت لك صوتي تحبيرا. If I knew that you were listening to me yesterday, if I knew that, I would beautify even my voice more. الله أكبر. العلماء قالوا, why Abu Musa was reciting the Quran beautifully and there is nobody there? Why he was making this? He could just recite normally. Nobody is listening. العلماء said, because he believes that jinn is listening. Yeah, and jinn is listening to Al-Quran. There is a whole surah talks about the listening of the jinn to Al-Quran. نَفَرٌ مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Allah, jinn is listening. Allah, yeah. Sometime when I raise my voice in the recitation, يعني some brothers, few people, become say, hey, Sheikh, you raise your voice too much. You know, why? Just, you know. I said, Ya أخي, you can listen to my voice when I'm reciting with my low pitches, but I would love to let al-jinn listen to the Quran. I wanted to burn bad jinn with al-Quran and let Muslim jinn love al-Quran and enjoy with the Quran. Because jinn has two categories, Muslim ones, non-Muslim ones. Muslim jinn, they love to listen to the Quran. They are Muslim like us. Not Muslim jinn, al-Quran is burning them. So let us burn the bad jinn and let good jinn enjoy to do not harm us in the masjid. Then the Prophet ﷺ was reciting the Quran and there were 100,000 sahabi. Imagine that. 100,000 sahabi. Is that right? Can you imagine that the sahaba weren't praying jama'ah? No, they were. Is that right? Dhuhr, Asr, Fajr, Isha, everything. Is that right? Okay. 100,000 sahabi without mics and speakers. Could you imagine, please, how the Prophet was raising his voice to let 100,000 people listen to his recitation? That why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرُ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. اصْدَعْ, raise your voice. When you recite the Quran, when you بلاغ القرآن, raise your voice. اصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرُ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. Ima, now, I just gave you the importance of al-maqamat because the only knowledge would let you beautify your voice is al-maqamat. Then the Prophet tells you, if you do not beautify your voice, you won't recite like us. You know, beautify your voice to recite like us, otherwise, try. How to try? Through al-maqamat signs. If you wanted to make it without al-maqamat signs, go ahead, but tell me how, please. You listen to the Qurra? Yeah, you listen to the maqamat. You're gonna come to this knowledge. you know, inshallah. Same thing that if you wanted to learn tajweed, it's same thing. How to learn tajweed? You listen to ulama tajweed, you listen to the qurra to learn how they make ghunna, how you go to ilm tajweed. Is that right? You learn fiqh, how? Yalla, what's the conditions of a salah? Istiqbal al-qibla, to have the qibla, that's fiqh knowledge. You're gonna go to the fiqh knowledge. With intention or without intention, you're gonna go. Is that right? Same thing. Just, I would love to start my lecture with this point, and I think inshallah it's clear now. Go ahead, Sheikh. There is a sister who just came. Okay, 11:45. Okay, inshallah, 11:45. We have sister. She's gonna make shahada, inshallah. Bismillah ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, takbir. Subhanallah. طيب, let me end this theoretical part with this story which happened to me in Calgary last Ramadan. I was in Masjid Akram Jumu'ah. That masjid, the capacity of the masjid is 10,000 people in Calgary. That's, I think, the biggest masjid in North America. Alhamdulillah, I was leading Taraweeh there. Then after I finished Taraweeh, one lady, Canadian lady, came to me and she said, I wanted to talk to you. I said, go ahead, sister. I was super busy, super tired, but I just, you know, go ahead, sister. She told me, two maqams make me Muslimah. Two maqams. I said, what? She said, yeah, maqam al-ajam, maqam al-nahawand. I kept listening for them 5 years. And when I listening to these two maqams, let me feel the beauty of the Quran, and I didn't understand one Arabic word. I was just hitting your videos and videos of other shuyukh and listen to these two maqams, maqam al-ajam and nahwat. Subhanak ya Allah. Naam. She became Muslim because of tahseen al-sawt, the beauty of the voice. Al-Imam Ibn Baz, rahimahullah, great alim. And I don't agree with a lot of his views, but he is great alim. Ibn Baz, rahimahullah. He passed away 2000 something in Saudi Arabia. And he was explaining the hadith, which is beautify your voice when you recite the Quran. He was explaining it. And he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, great statement. He said, when you beautify your voice in the Quran, there are three benefits gonna happen. Now go ahead, Sheikh Lam. He said, the first benefit, when people are beautifying the voice when they recite Quran, other people gonna listen to Al-Quran more. So imagine that if you recite the Quran with not good voice, like this, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. You're gonna be sleeping now, is that right? Yeah, if you recite the Quran beautifully, and the Qari is reciting the Quran like your Shaykh, mashallah, your Qari, mashallah, yeah, I'm pretty sure in Taraweeh, people won't like to leave the masjid. They wanted to just keep listening to the Qira'. But imagine if your Qari doesn't have good voice. People gonna leave the masjid and go to different masjid has qari, has good voice. Is that right? For same thing, subhanAllah, Ibn Baz said, rahimahullah, to beautify your voice in the Quran, people gonna listen to Al-Quran more. This is the first benefit. Then the second benefit, O Mawlana. He said the second benefit that when you recite Al-Quran beautifully, people gonna ponder Al-Quran more. Yeah, tadabbur Al-Quran. Even if you don't understand, you're gonna feel something like that Canadian lady. Allahu Akbar. Then he said the third benefit, if you recite the Quran beautifully, you're gonna make da'wah lil Islam through your voice. Id'u bi sawtik. Make da'wah through your voice, ya Habibi. And alhamdulillah, by the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more than 200 people, they become Muslim on my social media. Alhamdulillah, the karam min Allah, grace from God, not from me. Yeah, they listen to the Quran, they love it, they came through the channel. They announced, many of them they didn't even announce. Those who announced are 200 people. Da'wah lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through the recitation, listening to the beauty of Al-Quran. Al-Azim, subhanaka ya Rabb. طيب, even now this is the theoretical part. Let me go right now, inshallah, to the practical part. We have 8 styles. Al-Maqamat, the main maqamat are 8. The branchy maqamat are 500. We don't have time for that. Let us just stuck with the main ones. No qari in the world recites Al-Quran without hitting one from these 8 tombs. No one. Even those who do not accept, يعني, some people, may Allah forgive everyone, they don't like this knowledge asa from the beginning, and they are against the knowledge. When you ask them, okay, recite, ya habib. When they recite, they're gonna hit one from these 8 maqams. And I did it, يعني, with myself personally, with one sheikh. I do respect him so much. He was against al maqamat. I said, okay, Mawlana, recite, ya habib, without maqamat. He said, okay. Then he recited the Quran. He hits maqam rast. He said, okay, sheikh, now you recite maqam rast. He said, oh, I don't know that. How you don't know? Then you accuse people and you don't know. Now you recite maqam al-rast. Wallahi, sheikh, I don't know that. I thought that reciting by maqamat, that you bring musical things. You bring, okay, where is the musical things? Are we having a musical thing? In my bucket, there is a flute or something. We don't have musical things. The musician, actually, I'm so sorry for the musician. The musician is stolen the tunes from the natural of your the human being's voice, and they put it in their things. The tunes is there before even the concept of music, aslan. Sayyidina Dawood, alayhi salam, thousands of years ago. Allah is talking about his recitation. And he said, Ya jibalu, awibi ma'ahu wat-tayr, wa'alanna lahu al-haq. Oh mountains, oh birds, repeat after Dawood. When Dawood is reciting the Zabur, O mountains, O birds, repeat after him. The narration says that his voice would like make the mountains like, because of the echo of his voice, the mountains, the birds were just, the birds were repeating. Subhanallah, this is Sayyidina Dawood. That's why when Abu Musa al-Ash'ari was reciting the Quran beautifully, the Prophet ﷺ told him, لَقَدْ أُوتِيتَ مِزْمَارًا مِنْ مَزَامِيرِ آلِ دَوُودِ. You have some from the tunes which Dawood alayhi salam was using. You have some of them. Oh, Dawood before the music, aslan notion and concept, the musician, that's Sayyidina Dawood. The musician stolen these tunes from human beings natural, then they put it and they make it up with the fluent, with the piano, with whatever. I don't care about them. I do care about the grace which Allah gave it to me and you in your voice, in your throat. The natural one. That's what I do care about. طيب. فالمقامات are 8 مقامات. Let me start because of the time, inshallah. The first maqam and the most easy maqam is maqam al-bayati. Al-bayati in Arabic language mean, and this is by the way Arabic maqam. We have also Persian maqamat. We have Turkish maqamat. We have Kurdish maqamat. The Arabic one is maqam al-bayati. Al-bayati in Arabic language means to relax. To bayit, يعني to relax. At night, you're relaxing, that means at-tabiyit. So this maqam is so calm maqam. I prefer to recite it in Salat al-Fajr, also in Salat al-Isha, in Salat Qiyam al-Layl, that's the maqam. Qiyam al-Layli maqam. Maqam al-bayat. But how to recite with this maqam? Like this, Bismillah ar-Rahman.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا
Calm maqam, you bring it in the ayat which talks also about calmness. Allah is describing عباد الرحمن and he said, يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا When they are walking on the earth, they walk with calmness. Ah, شوفي, it fits now the meaning. يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا When jahilun are talking to them, they say, salam, salam. I don't like to continue that. Salam. The calmness, you know. Then you bring the calm tune to Let the meaning, God, you expose the meaning now through your voice. Allah, imagine if I recite same ayah with the same meaning without maqams. It will be like this. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Which better? The first one, is that right? SubhanAllah. Yeah. The beauty of the Qur'an. The beauty of the Qur'an. Because of this, for me, this is why the Prophet said, if you do not beautify, you won't recite like us. You have to beautify. That's why the Prophet was talking about that. Otherwise, we wouldn't also love Qur'an. Yeah, imagine of all Qur'an now, there is no Ba'a Abdul Basit. He recites by Maqamat. There is no Minshawi. Please. He recites with all Maqamat Minshawi. Forget about Mustafa Ismail. Forget about Husari. Forget about Muhammad Rifat. Forget about Imam Zuf al-Haram. Forget about Sheikh Mishari. Sheikh Ra'ad al-Kurdi. Forget about all these Qur'an. They, all of them recite with Maqamat. Yalla. Let us bar recite without Maqamat. Nobody of you gonna love Qur'an. Nobody of you gonna love Qur'an. Imagine if you recite without voice. SubhanAllah. That's maqam al-bayati, calm maqam. طيب, let's begin with the time. The second maqam, which is maqam al-rast. Al-rast is like excited maqam. Yeah, when you listen to it, you feel excitement. Some ayat, we need to feel excitement when we recite it. When you talk about the descriptions of God. When you talk about as-samawat, al-ard, the creations of Allah. Yeah, you need to feel excitement, is that right? Let me give you a small example. Fatiha, then. One or two ayah.
الحمد لله رب العالمين.
Now, it's different than the first one. The first one was calm one. Now, no, it's not calm. It's like you raised your voice and you went to a different tune now. Yes.
الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار.
سبحان الله. Yeah. Allah is talking about those who are pondering and thinking about the creations of Allah, the creations of the sky, the creations of the earth. They are thinking about it, they are pondering. يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا. They have dhikr when they are sitting. They have dhikr when they are standing. They have dhikr when they are laying down. I was arguing with someone. He hates those who make dhikr. I say, why, Sheikh? He said, yeah. How you make dhikr and sometimes you make it when you are jumping or you are sitting. Or how you make this? I told him, okay, what is the way that you have to make dhikr with? Just sit down and make dhikr. He said, when you pray, make dhikr. After prayer, you say, SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah, that's it. Wallahi. طيب, how to explain the ayah which says, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah is describing those who make dhikr, and He said, those who are making dhikr when they are standing, those who are making dhikr when they are sitting, those who are making dhikr when they are laying down. He said, okay, but He didn't say when they jump. He said, okay, when you jump, there is hadith says, when you got raised up, you say Allahu Akbar. When you go down, you say Subhanallah. When you raise a mountain or something, you say Subhanallah. You go down, you say Allahu Akbar. Two narrations. Yeah, imagine you play now. You play, just you play. You're running. And you wanted to remember Allah. You cannot remember Allah when you're running. When you're running, you see something and beauty from the beauties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are you gonna say? Subhanallah. Or you say Allahu Akbar. Yeah, for what's the problem to make dhikr? When you jump, when you run, when you sit, when you stand, when you lay down. It's not our topic, but just yani, it's the ayah subhanAllah reminds me of this story. Okay, let us come back. Yeah, now we finish two maqams, maqam al bayati wa maqam al rast. Let us go now to the third maqam, which is maqam al sabah. Sad maqam. Ya Shaykh, sad maqam. Is that ayat like sad ayat? Ya Allah, there are sad ayat. Hazina ayat, hazina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mathalan, talks about the death of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He passed away sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Talan, some people, they don't like the word of death when we talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's alive in his grave, taban. Walakin, he passed away. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this, innaka mayitun, wa innahum mayitun. طيب, when I remember the last minutes and moments of Rasulullah's life, I feel bad. Well, you feel good. I feel bad. I would love to let him alive until today, to meet him, to kiss his hand, to be with him. Is that right? When I recite this ayat, it gives me sadness. Yeah, I don't like that. Subhanallah. I don't like the idea that the Prophet gone. I believe that he gone because Allah told us that. But I love to just let him alive and subhanallah, meet with him now. Is that right? When I recite this ayat, I don't feel happy. Yeah, express by your sad through your voice. How? You use maqam al-saba. Al-saba gives you this feeling, sad feeling. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, sisters, you can join us if you don't mind, inshallah. We have available seats here, as you like. طيب, the ayah in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم. Even the ayah talks about the fitna which happened after Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away. Big fitna, right? Between Sahaba. Yeah. You happy when you recite ayat al-fitna? Yeah. No, you are not happy. You feel sad. Yeah. Express this sad bad through your voice. Yeah. We're gonna bring a sad melody, sad tune. يلا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم
سبحان الله أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم when he just if he passed it away mat or he got killed you just flip and you make fitna you fight to each other الله أكبر yeah I'm not feeling well when I'm reciting this ayah I feel sad, then I bring the sad tune when I'm reciting this ayat. Even now we finished three maqams. The sister comes, inshallah. If the sister comes to make shahada, inshallah ta'ala, we are so happy for her, and I'm so honored even to attend these, inshallah, great minutes, inshallah, and moments. Bismillah, sister. We're going to, inshallah, make it in Arabic language and in English language. But I prefer to start with English to let her just say it, inshallah. Normally, then we're going to make it in Arabic, inshallah ta'ala. Are you ready, sister, inshallah? You ready?
Yes.
Inshallah, bismillah. I bear witness. You just repeat after me, okay?
I am.
Okay. I bear witness.
I bear witness.
There is no God.
There is no God.
But Allah.
But Allah.
And Prophet Muhammad. And Prophet Muhammad. Yeah. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah, yeah. Come please. Just hug her. Yeah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her strengthness, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless her and bless her life, inshallah. Say ameen. Subhanallah. Yeah, and great moment, wallahi. Subhanallah. The person cannot imagine that one lady loves the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, feels something in her heart. She wants just to be a Muslim, inshallah, a mu'mina bi idhnillahi ta'ala.
Prophet Muhammad?
Yeah, we can get that. Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God.
He's the messenger of God.
And is the slave of God.
And he's the slave of God.
And Prophet Jesus?
And Prophet Jesus?
Is the slave of God.
Is the slave of God.
And messenger of God.
And messenger of God.
Takbir. Takbir. Okay, now just we're going to say it in Arabic language in half a minute. Ashhadu. أشهد
أشهد
أن لا
الله
إله
إله
إلا الله
إلا الله
وأشهد
وأشهد
أن محمد
أنا محمد
رسول الله
رسول الله
تكبير تكبير ما شاء الله سيستر مي الله سبحانه وتعالى bless you and bless your life إن شاء الله سبحان الله great moment yeah نعم yeah we're gonna make نهاوند now
thank you I'm so sorry
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless her and bless her life, bless her family, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give her strength, give her inshallah steadfastness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make her among those who are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any idols, those who are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with clear tawheed and oneness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather her and us in Jannat al-Firdaus. Say ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with al-anbiya, wal-siddiqeen, wal-shuhada, wal-salihin, wa-hasuna ulaika rafiqan ya rabbal alameen. طيب, we finish now maqam al-saba, wa maqam al-bayati, wa maqam al-rast. We finish three tunes, three styles. Let me go now to the fourth, inshallah, style bi-inni Allah ta'ala. Let us go with maqam al-ajam. The lady in Canada, she loves it so much and she become Muslim because al-ajam wa al-nahawand. Now, inshallah, we're going to talk about Ajam and Nahawand. Why that lady loves Ajam? Also, my wife, she loves Ajam so much. What's the point behind that? Ajam is Western tune. It is Western tune. Western. Then people of the West, they love to listen to it a lot. Subhanallah. يعني Western tune. طيب, الإسلام العظيم, القرآن العظيم, it's Quran, it's Arabic Quran, we know that. But when you recite the Quran, to reach to the minds and to let the ears of everyone loves it, you should recite it with all tunes. Eastern one, Western one, Northern one, Southern one. Because in Africa also, our brothers in Africa, they have also special tune of Maqam al-Bayati, like Sudani recitation, African recitation, Alhamdulillah. شوف. From the miracle of God that He makes Al Quran in this way, which you can recite it with all tunes. Imagine if you cannot recite with Western tunes, with African tunes. What about these guys? They are Muslim and subhanAllah, some of them have Islam and have Iman more than us. Alhamdulillah, هذا القرآن العظيم. This is the miracle of the Quran and actually the miracle of Arabic language. If you can make the recitation in this great book with all tunes. That's the point, subhanAllah. طيب, let us go now, inshallah, to Maqam al-Ajam.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm al-Din. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذب الثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها.
طبعا I switch it to sad one because Allah here is talking about people of Saleh when they killed the camel which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it to him. Ah, they killed it. فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم. Allah destroyed them. Subhanallah. Demdem, they disobeyed Allah. This is not sad, not good actually moment when disbelievers in that time disobeyed God and killed the sign which He sent it to them. I don't feel good actually for that. Yeah. You switch now to the sad tune which fits the meaning of the ayat which you recite. طيب. Let us go now to the fifth one, which is maqam al-nahawant. This is happy maqam. Allah. Imagine now Allah is describing believers and their spouses when they are entering Jannah. In Surah Yasin. إِنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ الْيَوْمَ فِي شُغُلٍ فَاكِهُونَ هُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُهُمْ فِي ظِلَالٍ عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ مُتَّكِئُونَ لَهُمْ فِيهَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَلَهُمْ مَا يَدَّعُونَ سَلَامٌ قَوْلًا مِنْ رَبِّ الرَّحِيمِ. Will you recite it like with sad melody? One big sheikh, without mentioning names, يعني, was reciting this ayat with sad melody, sad tune. Then I know him. Yeah, sheikh, your recitation was amazing. But why you used like sad melody? You're describing people of Jannah. You sad? You enter Jannah or what? He said, Wallahi, ya sheikh, I wanted to leave this maqam, but I couldn't. Because I don't know how to bring the happy one. But the Sheikh himself wanted when he was reciting to get out from the maqam and bring happy one, but he couldn't because he doesn't know other maqamat. See the importance of this knowledge? I said, Ya Sheikh, you let people cry. They should be happy. They're gonna enter Jannah. See the importance of this subhanAllah knowledge? Allahu Akbar. Yeah, now we're gonna recite this inshaAllah in happy tune, which is maqam al-nahawant.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام سلام قولا من رب رحيم
سلام قولا من رب رحيم The next ayah right away there is a transition in the surah Allah start talk about people of hellfire. وَامْتَازُ الْيَوْمَ أَيُّهَا الْمُجْرِمُونَ Come here, O criminals. على طول, transition. You have been now to make transition also with the maqamat. They were reciting with happy tune, describing people of Jannah. And now Allah is describing people of hellfire. How to make this transition? Like, you know, sour, sweet, like hot, cold. Yeah, how? Yes, it needs, طبعاً, knowledge. And it needs also practicing a lot. Let me just give you a small example.
سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتاز اليوم أيها المجرمون
I brought the sad melody. وامتاز اليوم أيها المجرمون
ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان
Did I not say to you, do not worship شيطان? Allah is talking now. يعبدوا الشيطان. I'm not happy for that. Yeah. Then I brought the sad سبحان الله too. طيب. يبقى now we finished. الصبا. نهواند. عجم. بياتي. رست. You still have three. Let us go now to maqam al-Hijaz. Al-Hijaz, it's Arabic maqam. It comes from Hijaz region. Mecca, Medina, that area. And people there, even muadhinin, they have a special tune. When you go to haram, if I make now adhan, you're going to tell me it's haram or not. Through what? Through the tune. It's a Hijazi tune.
Allahu Akbar,
That's a Hijazi tune. Imagine if muadhins of al-haram do not use maqamat. The adhan would be like this. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, People gonna leave Islam, astaghfirullah. Yeah. People love adhan al-haram. طيب الشيخ, different maqamat of adhan is there? Yes. Like Egyptian, مثلا, adhan, they use maqam al-rasl to seek. How? It's like in this way. It's different, completely different than adhan al-haram. It's beautiful also. Like this.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
It's different maqamat. For those who are against the maqamat, good luck. Just you go, you know, and you make adhan like this. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Come on, guys. See the beauty of the adhan when it comes with the maqamat. Subhanallah. طيب. Now we have we finish now مقام الحج. طبعا انت شيخ انت شد مقام حجاز الاذان, we need مقام حجاز القراءه. yeah. بسم الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين.
Okay, you listen now to Hijaz qira'ah from me with the same tune. I'm gonna let you listen to Imam al-Haram and he's reciting with the same tune to know that maqam al-Hijaz in California, in San Francisco and in Mecca, 10,000 miles. Same too. How, ya Sheikh? Now, give me a second. Bismillah. Imam al-Haram, Sheikh Bandar Balila. You know him? When you go Haram there, you're gonna enjoy if you listen to his recitation. Give me a second. Yes, here.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين طور سينين والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم.
Okay. That's مقام الحجاز. So from Kansas, when I was recording this, from Kansas to Mecca. With the same tune, مقام الحجاز الغريب, بكل حجاز الغريب.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم.
It's the beauty of مقام الحجاز. طيب, we still have two مقامات. مقام الكرد and مقام السيكا. الكرد, it's Kurdish مقام. It comes from Kurdistan area. In Iraq, north of Iraq, Turkey, Syria, in the Kurdish area, they have this tune. And it's so simple tune, so calm tune. Nobody doesn't like it. Everyone loves this maqam. Subhanallah. And this maqam is the preference for our sisters, for the women. They prefer this one. I don't know why. Yani, scientifically, I don't know why, but they love this maqam so much. Subhanallah. Maqam al-Kurd. طيب, how to recite مقام الكرد like this.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان
مقام الكرد beautiful يعني in صلاة التراويح for me I use this مقام all the time in تراويح why calm one usually in صلاة التراويح my voice doesn't feel good because every night I recite like one hour you know sometimes I'm tired sometimes I'm traveling this مقام give you just example I was in South Africa and I was so tired and you know my voice was so tired and just I use this one I'm gonna show you now مقام النهوند مقام سوري الكرد yes here that's TikTok guys give me a second yes here قالت لهم رسلهم from سورة إبراهيم when you bring this مقام and you make استرسال you recite with it you won't get out from this مقام from the beauty of it مقام الكرد
رسلهم أفي الله شك فاطر السماوات والأرض يدعوكم ليغفر لكم من ذنوبكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى قالوا إن أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا تريدون أن تصدونا عما كان يعبد آباؤنا فأتونا بسلطان مبين قالت لهم رسلهم إن نحن إلا بشر مثلكم ولكن الله يمن على من يشاء من عباده وما كان لنا أن نأتيكم بسلطان إلا بإذن الله وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون وما لنا ألا نتوكل على الله وقد هدانا سبلنا ولنصبرن على ما آذيتمونا وعلى الله فليتوكل المتوكلون
That's طبعاً dialogue happened between the Rusul, the messengers and their peoples and Allah is describing this dialogue. Dialogues in the Quran, it comes with kurd right away. It gives you, subhanAllah, the feeling of these situations which happened between the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and their peoples. Okay, last maqam now is maqam as-sika. It's ultimate happiness, يعني. When you are so happy, you recite ayat, يعني, has happiness. Like Allah is promising you to be in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared a lot of issues for you in Jannah. When you recite these kind of ayat, you could bring this maqam, maqam as-sika.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وأصحاب اليمين ما أصحاب اليمين في سدر مخضود وطلح منضود وظل ممدود وماء مسكوب وفاكهة كثيرة لا مقطوعة ولا ممنوعة.
Allah here is describing the beautiful things which He prepared to believers in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. طبعاً this maqam also you can use it in nasheed. It looks like مثلاً طلع البدر علينا. I would love inshallah to end with this, then I'm gonna open the questions and answers inshallah. Nasheed, طلع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع. هذا النشيد it's not mentioned in hadith. But this nasheed is mentioned in narrations as a متواتر nasheed. إحنا we talk about deen, we have to be careful. Some people they said this nasheed is hadith. لا, it's not hadith. It's narration. It comes to us by التواتر. Chains, generations after generations, they believe that people of Medina, they received the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم with this nasheed. It's narration. It's not hadith. No hadith books talk about this nasheed. There are narrations. It comes in Kutub al-Siyar that the Sahaba received the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with this great nasheed. But before I make nasheed, there is a fiqhi thing I would love to talk about it. Some people, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them and us, they believe that making a nasheed in the masjid is bid'ah. It's haram. Do not make nasheed in masjid. It's haram. They believe that. طيب. طبعا I don't agree with that. Why? Because I have the dalil. Adilla. What's the dalil, ya Shaykh? From the sunnah. There are four incidents happened in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Proof to us that nasheed is okay to make it in the masjid. Four incidents. طيب. What's the incidents? The first incident, people of Habasha, disbelievers people came to the Masjid al-Nabawi, and this narration narrated in Kutub al-Hadith. So you cannot say it's wrong. Yeah, it's mentioned in Kutub al-Hadith. This group of Habasha people, they came to Masjid al-Nabawi to know something about Islam. Then after they finished talking with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they told him, "We want to play with the sticks in the Masjid." If it is haram and bid'ah, he would tell them right away, no, get out of the masjid, you can play there. Just, you know, in the time of Rasulullah, there is no aslan walls and roofs and masjid, just place. They were praying in it. He could tell them, just go 20 meters out and play there. He did not do that. He told them, go ahead and play. And the narration says, the hadith says, Aisha radiallahu anha, get out from her room. And told the Rasul and put her chin on the shoulder of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and told him, "I want to watch them." Yeah, Subhanallah. Then he said, "Yeah, watch." Then, a couple of minutes, he told her, "It is okay now. It's enough." She said, "No, it's not enough. I would love to watch more." And he kept her watch more in the masjid. طبعاً, some narration says that they were dancing, but I won't accept this narration. They were at least playing with the sticks like this in the masjid. And he allowed them. He didn't say bid'ah. He didn't say haram. He said, what is the qudsiyah of the masjid? You know, you have to be polite when you are. Yeah, طبعاً, of course, we have to be polite. But he allowed them to do that. That's the first incident. Yeah. The second incident. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When someone was stealing in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or making haram, fahisha or whatever, the Prophet was making had the punishment for those who were making something haram. Is that right? The hudud in his time sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do you think that he was making the hudud in the masjid or not? He was making the hudud in the masjid. The punishment was in the masjid. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the masjid he was making hudud. You talk about nasheed. Nasheed, just nasheed, just kind of dhikr. Like that hudud, punishment in the masjid. That's the second incident. The third incident, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making i'tikaf. Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu anhu sahaba. He told the sahaba, if you wanted to eat, have suhoor, have iftar, do not get out the masjid. For they were eating and drinking in the masjid. And there is no that time a place for food and the gym and la la ya habibi. In the masjid. They were eating and drinking and sleeping. But he just told them, you cannot bring, you know, your wives and no. This is not in the masjid. لا تباشروهن وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد. No, this is not allowed in the masjid. Other issues, eating, drinking, sleeping, reciting Quran, making dhikr, making nasheed, making hudud, playing with the sticks. A last incident. I'm gonna, after that, inshallah, I'll have the nasheed, then listen to your question, inshallah. Last incident proves to you it's okay to make nasheed in the masjid is people of Najran city, Christian people from Najran city, they came to debate with Rasulullah in the masjid. After they finished the debate, Sunday comes because they stayed in the masjid 3 days. This narration narrated in Kutub al-Sunnah and even Sheikh al-Islam ibn al-Qayyim mentioned it. Yeah. After they finished the debate, they were in the back of the masjid and Sunday comes. And they worshipped their God, which we don't agree about that, in the masjid. Yeah, making this in the masjid. And the Sahaba came to the Prophet. They make, you know, something not good. For us as Islam, this is not Islam, this is shirk. They make these issues in the masjid, Rasulullah, just kick them out. The Sahaba said, no. They come to learn about Islam. Have we just kicked them out? No, let them do this. They make it in the back of the masjid. وَرَبُّ الْبَيْتِ The Lord of the house knows that we don't agree about them. But, you know, we are hosting them. We cannot just kick them out. So the etiquette of Rasulullah ﷺ. Not like those hardliners nowadays. If a woman enters the masjid and she doesn't cover her hair or whatever, they right away, oh, get out! Wait, wait. The Prophet allowed non-Muslim people to worship their God in the masjid. Why? For the da'wah, for the sake of da'wah. Lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the point here comes. Some of this group converted to Islam because of the, subhanallah, the tolerance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's a tolerant guy. Adab Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said he allowed us to make this in his mosque. Allahu Akbar. The beauty. You tell me about nasheed. The nasheed, there is no comparison between nasheed and these four incidents, which I said it for you. I'm talking with Adilla, by the way. Studying Al-Azhar, alhamdulillah, master degree. Here we talk about Adilla. Talk about deen, you talk about Adilla. Dalil, id dalil. What Allah said about this, what Rasulullah said, what the Sahaba, Sira, Ulama, Fuqaha. Come and talk. Bid dalil, bil hujja. You know. طيب. يبقى now, let us make a طلع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع. وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله دعا. يلا, we're gonna make it with مقام, inshallah, also a seek. يلا. I'm gonna say it, then you're gonna repeat after me. Okay, guys, inshallah. طيب.
طلع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وأجاب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع
I'm gonna say it again. I'm gonna reduce my voice a little bit to match with your voice. Bismillah. بسم الله.
طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر المطاع جئت شرفت المدينة مرحبا يا خير داع.
طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
فبلال صار حرا وكذا الشيخ الأبر عندما واجه ظلما صار محمود الخصال.
طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر المطاع جئت شرفت المدينة مرحبا يا خير داع.
مرحبا يا خير داع. طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
فبلال صار حرا وكذا الشيخ الأبر عندما واجه ظلما صار محمود الخصال. صار محمود الخصال.
طالع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
ما دعا لله داع.
طيب, being that we talk about Rasulullah, let us make inshallah one more nasheed, then we're gonna inshallah listen to your questions inshallah. طيب, nasheed Mustafa, 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 sallallahu ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
مصطفى مصطفى منبع للصفا سيد الأنبياء مشعل بالوفا كان في عطفه لليتامى دفا.
مصطفى مصطفى
منبع للصفا سيد الأنبياء مشعل بالوفا كان في عطفه لليتامى دفا. حن قلبي له زاد شوقا إليه ليس أرجو سواه شربة من يدي الصلاة علي والسلام علي للسماء ارتقى فأتى بالنقى وغدا وجهه نيرا مشرقا كان من هديه حين حان اللقاء قال فلتذهبوا أنتم الطلقاء
مصطفى مصطفى
أنبع للصفا سيد الأنبياء مشعل بالوفا كان في عطفه لليتامى دفا حن قلبي له زاد شوقا إلي ليس أرجو سوى شربة من يدي الصلاة علي والسلام علي كان في هديه منهجا وسطا كانت تسعده بسمة الفقراء سيد في الكرم قمة في العطاء
مصطفى مصطفى
منبع للصفا سيد الأنبياء مشعل بالوفا كان في عطفه لليتامى دفا مصطفى
صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now inshallah we have 15 minutes for questions and answers inshallah ta'ala. We're ready for you guys inshallah. If anyone has any question, we're ready inshallah to answer the question. Bismillah, sister.
We have mic here. If someone would just hold the mic and give it to anyone who wants to ask, I'm going to appreciate this.
My voice is quite loud. Okay, assalamu alaikum. Brother, you see in the Quran, or maybe I've also read the hadith, a lot of hadith about in Sahih Bukhari, I guess. So I read once that someone who's struggling to read the Quran, of course Quran has five rites first of all, and of course most of the people maybe here know about that. So the five rites is first to believe in the Quran as the book of Allah. Second is, maybe you'll go and narrate that. And after the five rites, of course, and when it comes to reading, it's said that one who's struggling to read, you know, someone who's become a new Muslim, of course, or someone who's a Muslim, but he or she doesn't know how to read the Quran right and is struggling to read. And Allah says he rewards that person even more, yet double the reward he gets for being able to. And then inshallah, if he or she masters that, he goes on to the next level. But of course, I now come to know that if somebody has the desire but has not been able to find someone who could teach her, it comes to a woman, she's looking for a woman to teach her, where would she go about doing that? I mean, what would be the easiest way to go about it?
Okay, sister is talking about, what about those who are reciting the Quran and they have difficulty when they recite the Quran? I'm gonna give you glad tidings from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And to be a companion of the Quran, you have to be among five levels. There are five levels. The first level, those who cannot read and those who cannot recite, they cannot even know, understand Aslan or understand Arabic language. And they cannot recite the Quran at all. I have glad tidings for them. If they just listen to the Quran, if they just listen to the Quran, they will be about or from the first category of those who are companion of the Quran al-Azim. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asked Abdullah ibn Mas'ud to recite. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud told him, how could I recite the Quran and the Quran came down on you? You recite, not me. Then the Prophet said, I love to listen to the Quran from different people. For now the Prophet, according to this hadith, was listening to the Quran. For those who are listening only to the Quran, they're gonna take ajr and reward, and they're gonna make sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For the first category of people, those who cannot read, take this glad tiding if you just listen. The second category, those who can read Al Quran, not recite. We can just read it. You know Arabic? We can read. We cannot recite. Yeah, they have also another glad tiding from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Iqra'u al-Qur'an." Read the Quran. He doesn't say "Rattilu al-Qur'an." Rattilu in different dalil. But this "Iqra'u al-Qur'an." فَإِنَّهُ يَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ شَفِيعًا لِأَصْحَابِهِ. The Quran will be helpful for those who were reading it. طيب, but this is the second level. The third level, to recite the Quran. طيب يا شيخ, I have horrible pronunciation. I can't recite the Quran properly. Take this dalil from what our sister said. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الماهر بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام البررة والذي يقرأ القرآن ويتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق له أجران. The one who is reciting the Quran and there is a ta'ta'a. يعني he makes mistakes in each ayah. He doesn't leave any ayah except he makes mistakes. يتتعتع. This is the تعتع in Arabic language. What about if you do that? You're gonna take double أجر. Double أجر. Yeah, because it's so hard for you, and you try to do your best. That's the third level. يبقى إيه? Listening, reading, reciting. The fourth one, to make ترتيل. Reciting the Quran by أحكام التجويد. The masters بقى ما شاء الله. This is الماهر بالقرآن. Allah said, the Prophet ﷺ said, he will be among the angels at the Day of Judgment. مع السفرة الكرام البررة. ده الواحد وده. مع السفرة الكرام البررة. He will be مع السفرة, مع الملائكة. There is another translation or explanation of السفرة means the prophets even. الله أكبر. That's the fourth one. The fifth level, the one who is listening, reading, reciting, make ترتيل أحكام التجويد, beautifying the voice, which is the maqamat which we're talking about. That's make tahbir al-Qur'an, we call it. Like Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. Tahbir al-Qur'an, beautifying the voice. And that, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks about tartil al-Qur'an, and he said, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like what I said in the hadith, he said that, تَغَنُّوا بِالْقُرْآنَ حَسِّنُوا الْقُرْآنَ بِأَصْوَاتِكُمْ, like what I said. That was the answer. How to do that if you do not have teachers, and I have fatwa, I even wrote it before and I said it in my masjid there. It is not obligatory act, it is sunnah act to learn from any teacher from any gender. You can, you know, make مثلاً for Zoom call, you can close or turn off the camera, you can just leave the audio working, and you can learn like now what you are learning now, you are sitting with us now. There is no any stigma for that. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha was talking to people to teach them the deen. She was telling them what the Prophet ﷺ was saying to her. And she was talking like that in front of men. If it is haram, the Prophet, لا, without hijab. One time it was without hijab. Without hijab. Without hijab, not hijab al-ra's, without a cover, like between them and men. No. One time she was praying, alayha ridwanullah, and Abu Huraira came and said that the Prophet ﷺ said this and this and this, and he did not continue, did not complete the hadith which the Prophet said. After she finished the salah, she get out. The hadith says she get out of her room and she told the sahaba, come here. He told you what the Prophet said, but he didn't continue. Let me tell you the continuation of the hadith. So it wasn't hijab between her, and hijab means like wall or something, not the hijab al-ras. She definitely was covering her hair. I'm not talking about hijab, which is the physical hijab. I'm talking about the wall. Sometimes she was narrating a hadith and there are a wall, and sometimes she wasn't. Yeah, I just told you now, when she told the Prophet, I wanted to watch people when they are playing sticks. There is no hijab. She told him, I wanted to see. And she put her chin and he told her, it's not enough. She said, no. But what is the hijab? Who said this? La, in Sahih al-Bukhari, she said that. I challenge anyone to bring. La, that's the explanation. Listen to me, sister. Listen to me. This is the explanation of hardliners, those who believe that you have to wear niqab. These guys, they misunderstand the hadith and they put this from their own. The hadith in al-Bukhari does not say it was under. No, the hadith says literally. I memorized the hadith when I was like 7 years old. The hadith says literally that she put her chin on the shoulder of the Prophet and she asked him to continue watching people who were playing with the sticks, and he told her it's okay. Then he looked at her and told her, is that enough? She said, no, it's not enough. And he allowed her to continue watch that. But there is another hadith in al-Bukhari when the guy asked her to show him how the Prophet was taking a shower, then she put a wall. And she told him the Prophet was taking shower like this and this and this and this. Yeah, I know both. Yeah. Okay, is there any other question, inshallah? Yes, sister, go ahead. Oh, but then, sorry, sister, just there is another also dalil, proves to me it's okay. That what do you think about the Sahaba were fighting with the army of men in the war? What? They were fighting together, men and women. In one army, Sayyida Safiya, I have 10 Sahabiyat. They were with the Muslim army in that time fighting with them. Yeah, they were like making shield, make like a fire. Can we learn? They were fighting with Muslim people in the same army. Those hardliners, they won't affect, inshallah, our deen. Yani, they just try to make it haram and without any adillah. The Aisha was sitting with people with her modesty, mashallah, narrating hadith for them. The Sahabiyat were fighting with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some Sahabiyat even were making nursing those who got injured in Muslim army that time. They were bringing them and nursing them. Ya Sahabiyat, in Sahabiyat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with modesty, mashallah, haya, no problem for that, inshallah. Go ahead, sister, bismillah. No. It's big difference between qira'at and maqamat. Maqamat is the tunes. Qira'at is the accents of the sahaba, those who recited the Quran. There is, مثلا, for example, wa-duha. Qira'at, مثلا, any qira'at, warsh or hamza, مثلا, bil-imala, wa-duhi. Now I can recite wa-duha, wa-duhi with same maqam. Like this. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. مقام حجاز. Okay, with حمزة مثلا أهو. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضي. This is Hamza, this is Hafs, and both of them with the same maqam, which is maqam al-Hijaz. They are different. Maqamat is different than qira'at. Unfortunately, there is no books talks about it because it comes with the voice. But on YouTube, you're gonna find thousands of videos. I made 5,000, and there are other mashayikh, they made also hundreds of videos. You go, it's like ocean. Yeah, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Any question? Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Jazakallah khairan for the sharing the knowledge. So how long does it take to master like some of the tunes, and what's the like practical steps, and how often we need to like practice in order to improve?
Every maqam for me is gonna take from 3 to 4 months if you listen to the maqam a lot. Like what I said yesterday in our event there in the masjid, that in San Francisco I heard there is a lot of traffic. فَإِنْتَ يُو when you are in your car for 1 hour per day, you play recitation of Quran by one maqam only. For example, they start with maqam al-rast, for example. Every day for 3 months, you don't listen any qira'ah except with maqam al-rast when you are in your car, for example. You play rast. Sheikh Sudais recites rast. Sheikh Hudhayfi recites maqam al-rast. Sheikh Juhani sometimes recites. Imams of al-Haram, Sheikh مثلا عبد الباسط recites a lot of rust. You just listen to rust. You write مقام rust. عبد الباسط مقام rust. مشاري مثلا العفاسي مقام rust. Anyone you like, you write مقام rust. Then you stuck. You listen. You listen. You listen. In 3 months or 4 months, I'm gonna tell you your recitation will be completely different. Because the only secret to improve your recitation is listening. When I'm teaching people, I'm just let them listen. Then I give them the tune. Then I let them repeat. It's listening and repeating. That's how to learn.
So can we, once we like put on the like recitation, can we go with the recitation, like speak at the same time, recite with the sheikh, or we need to just listen?
That after you listen a lot, you can repeat with the sheikh. That's a second step. But you have to listen first to receive the tune in your mind. You know, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. This is Maqam al-Bayati. Imagine if I recite like this 1 hour. Yeah, you just listen to this tune. After that, I'm pretty sure if you have small talent in your ears, you're gonna just repeat it and say it. That's how to learn Maqamat. Yeah. Fadal Shaykh. Ahlan alaykum as-salam.
These are the tunes, the maqamat you've mentioned are the known ones.
No.
Have you found a tune, your own tune, out of moments of ishq or and can do you have an example?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you. There are 8 maqams. Nobody can make anything with them. But there are branchy maqamat, branches. Like it comes from all these 8, but you add little bit things. There are more than 500. Yes, I make my own combination. Which is مقام الكرد and مقام النهواند ومقام السيكا والصبا المقام البكيري. That's my thing that I collected between all these مقامات and I make my cocktail. That's mine. يعني you bring many melodies and you put it together, but you have to choose آيات has multiple meanings to fit all these مقامات, which is they are, you know, it comes. فI made it in سورة الرحمن. Yeah, that's المقام البكيري. Okay, so يخرج
فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كل من عليها فان كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يسأله من في السماوات والأرض كل يوم هو في شأن فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان
I started Kurd, then I went Sika, then I end Sabah. Yeah, sometimes also I bring also Maqam al-Hijaz. You make combination in 3 or 4 ayat. But يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان يخرج من Allah is talking about the creation of him. Then كل من عليها فان Everyone gonna go. Then after that, يسأله من في السماوات والأرض كل يوم هو في شأن. People are asking Allah every day something. شوف 3 different meanings. Creation of God, asking from people, everyone gonna go. So you can bring this combination. It's so hard طبعا to find the ayat has multiple meanings and multiple transitions in one place. Yeah. Any other questions, inshallah? تفضل أخي, بسم الله. You brother, you.
Thank you. Shaykh Ibrahim, جزاك الله خير, بارك الله فيك. Just quick question. I know that musicians also use maqamat. Is there any difference between maqamat used in reciting Quran and maqamat used in singing?
Good question. Musicians also use mics and speakers. Musicians also, you know, use things that the Qurra use. The point here, let us bring to the origin, the asl al-sawt. Now, صحابة تابعين أنبياء they were using their voice with these all tunes. Why? How to prove this? I'm gonna prove it for you first, then I'm gonna answer the question. We wanted to make sure that the Prophet and the Sahaba were reciting with all these tunes. How to know that? How to prove that? There is no hadith talks about this. Like what I said in the beginning of the lecture, there is no hadith talk about ghunna and mad. But how to know? Pretty sure that the Prophet and the Sahaba were using these tunes. I'm gonna prove it to you right now. We receive the Quran by tawatur. Is that right? How to receive the Quran? Tawatur. We didn't see the Prophet when he was reciting, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We receive it by at-tawatur. It chains, chains, it chains. Thousands of as-sahaba recited, thousands of at-tabi'een, hundreds of thousands of tabi'at until today. Is that right? The first step happened between how the sahaba and the generation after them and tabi'een until 100 years ago. There is a transition happened when the recorders come. Let us go to the first qurra recorded their voice, because definitely they were reciting like those who came before them. The whole entire qurra, those who recorded their voice, I collected, على فكرة, يعني 99% of them, more than 3,000 qari. Starting from Sheikh Rifat, the first qari records his voice, Sheikh Muhammad Rifat, until Sheikh Ra'd al-Kurdi, wherever, until today. No qari recites without maqamat. But now we have two scenarios, Sheikh. Either the Prophet, the Sahaba were reciting with all these maqamat, then these Qurra nowadays are reciting like them, or, astaghfirullah, another scenario, that the whole entire Qurra nowadays reciting in the way which is the Prophet and the Sahaba, they wouldn't recite. And in this scenario, that Al-Qur'an, which is among our hands, it's not the Qur'an which in the time of Rasulullah. And this scenario is falsehood, because Allah said, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرِ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Allah saved Al-Qur'an, protected Al-Qur'an. For 100% being the whole entire Qurra in the world nowadays, reciting by all maqamat, which is 8, that means the Prophet and the Sahaba, 100%, they were reciting with all maqamat. Otherwise, we have problem in at-tawatur. And this is not right, because Allah said, He saved the Qur'an. Khalas, this is the first point. If 100% they were reciting by al-maqamat, that's the first part of the question. How to know that? By at-tawatur. طيب. Now, let's come to the second thing. Musicians are using same tunes of the voice. Good luck for them. They are using mics and speakers, and they stolen the natural tunes from the Qurra, from regular people. They stolen it, and they put it in their equipments and their alat. They did this. They made that. They make mustana'. It comes from the roots of the natural of people, of the voice of people. That's why Allah is talking about Dawood and said, Ya jibalu awwibi ma'ahu wat-tayr. على فكرة سيدنا داود, it comes before they create the musician, the music, and the musician thinks. Dawood comes like maybe 10,000 years ago. There is no music at that time. And Allah is talking about good voice. Subhanallah. And my answer for you, yes, they're using the same thing, but they stolen these things from our Qurra and from the natural of the voice itself. They stood in it and they made it. Let them make it. They use mics now. Have I just stopped using mic? Musician, are you? Let them use it. Use mic. This their field. It comes with same thing, because it's the same thing, Sheikh. We talk about voice. We talk about voice. They use same thing, but they put it in their alat. We make it with our alat, the tabi'i alat which Allah created for us. For the question again, did the Prophet recite with it or not? I don't care about musician. Did the Prophet, that's the question, recite by these maqamat or not? 100% he did. Otherwise, Al-Quran nowadays is not the Quran which he was reciting. وَالْعَيَادِ بِاللَّهِ. Because we receive the Quran by the voice, by listening. بالتواتر. Is that right? Do you have anything else? Yes, Sheikh. Go ahead. Bismillah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
Actually, I have a few questions, so I summarize it into maybe one or two. First, it's impossible for Ajami to know the Arabic ayat and to do the
Arabic almost, tunes, you see.
No, the meaning of the ayat, so that he can do the muqamat for each and every ayat.
Yeah. So let me answer this question first. Okay. he said that some people they don't understand Arabic. For how he gonna learn maqamat because he doesn't know the meaning. For me, I advise all, even my huffaz. I was in South Africa and Canada. I called the huffaz. I said, now you recite this para, you recite this chapter in Taraweeh. And I know that you don't know the meaning and you know maqamat, but you don't know how to match, how to fit. Now, before you go to Taraweeh, you learn the meaning of the ayat. You just stuck 2 hours, 3 hours per day. You just learn the meaning. Yalla, you recite now Surah Al-Baqarah, سَيَقُولُ السُّفَهَاءُ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Yalla, now you read the translation, you read the meaning for 2-3 hours, then use the maqamat based on the meaning which you learn. And I said, Sheikh al-Baqamat is the highest level. Before that, a lot of levels. You read, you listen, you recite, you learn tajweed, you learn the meaning, then you go to the last thing. That you bring the maqam, it should fit the meaning of the ayat. That's the first question. Go ahead.
So the next question is that usually we, in our 5 daily prayers, when we do the qiraat, it usually took a longer time. So is there any way to move it a bit faster?
Yeah, I don't understand.
The way we
recite?
Yeah.
لا, there is أحكام تجويد شيخ. بمعنى, there is حدر قراءة. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. شوف, إن, I make it too حركة, but I make it so fast a little bit. You can't do that. In قراءة الحدر. But there are مدود, you cannot do this with it, like المد الكلمي المثقل اللازم. ولا الضاء, you should make it 6 حركة. There is no way here. But the غنة itself, it comes with many, you know, مقياس, many measurement. حدر سريع, إن الله, طيب بطيء, إن الله وملائكته, طيب, you make it slowly, like القراءة المجودة. إن الله وملائكته يصلون. شوف الغنة, the first غنة, the second غنة, the third غنة are different based on the measurement which you gonna put it. But some أشياء like المدود, you cannot play with المدود. You pray ترتيل, you read, and you make it with the same measurement, 2, 4, 6 haraka, it should comes like that in all ayat, especially al-mudud al-muthaqqal al-lazima. Okay, but that's something about tajweed, now not maqamat.
Yeah. Okay. So can you give me an example of Surah Al-Fatiha with the hadr sari?
Al-hadr sari? Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen ar-Rahman ar-Rahim malik yawm al-deen. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. 15 seconds.
جزاك الله خير.
الله يبارك فيك. جزاك. Any other question? Brother there. بسم الله. Sisters, inshallah, we come back.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum salam, brother.
Quick question. Yeah, can you only use maqamat for Quran? Like, can you use maqamat for dua, maybe?
Yeah, of course. Of course, you can use maqamat in dua. You can use maqamat in nasheed. Bussa, Sheikh, anything has ghunna and mad, it should come with maqamat. Let me give you an example. Yalla, now. مثلا, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin fil awwaleen. في غنة هنا. أوكي. اللهم صل على محمد في الأول. إخفاء. طيب أهو. When you come to the word of غنة, your voice should come to the one from مقامات. Otherwise, if you said اللهم صل على محمد في الأول, okay, there is no مقام now. Yes, you beautify your voice a little bit to bring غنة or مد. You're gonna go to enter one from the 8 مقامات. اللهم صل على محمد في الأول. حجاز. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين. سيك. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. بياتي. الله. يا شيخ. Being that you beautify your voice in تجويد غنة or مد, right away you're gonna bring one from the مقامات. That's why I was talking about a big sheikh. He's against maqamat. I said, go ahead. recite without maqamat, and he did it without maqamat. He said, الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم. He said, she without maqamat. I would say, okay, continue. بيني وبينك المد يا حبيب. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هنا أوقف يا حبيبي. Your voice إيه؟ It changed. Now you bring مقام البياتي. Why? Because the mad comes. فإني مد إني غنة. This is the test of your مقام. That's why when I'm testing people what is their مقام, I listen to them in غنة and مد. In 2 seconds. I'm gonna inshallah recognize your مقام right away. يلا شيخ بسم الله.
السلام عليكم. Quick question is that, is there a way to determine what maqam I'm using when I'm just like reciting?
Yes, of course.
Because I recite a lot and I don't know what maqam is.
Recite, Sheikh, go ahead. Recite al-Fatiha.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
You start with Hijaz and you end with Kurd. You have two maqams, mashallah. That's good. Any question from woman side before we come? Yes, sister, go ahead. Okay. Alaykum as-salam. Ahlan wa sahlan. Anti, when you recite Al-Quran Al-Kareem suddenly, like what I did with the brother now, right away you're going to bring the maqam which fits your voice. When you recite suddenly, you know, ask, recite now. طبعاً يعني I know because we have men and women, some people don't agree about that, I don't prefer that now. But how to know your maqam when you recite Al-Quran suddenly in front of Sheikh, then if the Sheikh knows maqamat, he's going to tell you right away your maqam. Then you stuck back with this maqam, you listen more, you go with more videos, you try to practice, because people got nervous when they got tested. Then the first thing come to your mind, the maqam which already you recited by it all the time. Every qari has 2 or 3 maqams, by the way. He can learn more. But every qari has 2 or 3 maqams. That's the, like the sheikh now, 2 maqams. I'm pretty sure if he recited more, I'm going to discover the third one. You know? So that's why. Yeah, jazakumullah khair. Okay, any other question here?
Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh. Shukran jazeera.
Allah ibarak fiqh, Shaykh.
You know Sheikh Abdul Basit, Abdul Samad?
Habibi, Sheikh Abdul Basit.
No. He has a beautiful voice. He has extremely exceptional way of can you tell us which style? And very often I've noticed he goes melodiously and then stop. Goes to normal. Can you comment on
he that? Recites by Maqam al-Sika wal-Rast all the time. Especially the most famous qira'ah for him, he was in Lahore when he was reciting al-Duha. Imagine if Sheikh Abdul Basit was reciting al-Duha like this, wal-Duha, wal-Laydi, al-Asaja. You know how many millions watched this video? 250 million people. Yeah, على نفس واحد من الضحى. يعني I try, but my voice has hurt me from yesterday. I have flu, so it's not like full, but يعني I can do it. I will try, inshallah.
Yes. Yeah,
when he stops, he ends the melody which he was reciting with it, then he chooses another one to start again with different melody. That's what he's doing all the time. But I will try inshallah to just imitate. Maqamat, it's like circle, has 4 steps. Listening to the tunes, receiving the tunes, feeling the tunes, expressing the tunes through 8 ways. That's the maqamat, the definition of Bakir. That's Bakiri definition. طيب, let me go with the duha. I will try. I can't do it, but I will try, inshallah.
الضحي والليل إذا سجي ما ودعك ربك وما قلي ولا الآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف
يعطيك ربك فترضى. Just my breath got off, but if I'm practicing and I'm reciting and I'm with my full energy, I did it a lot before. Yeah. ولا سوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. Let me make it when I'm standing. Inshallah, I can. I'll try. Sheikh Abdul Basit, the best qari comes last 100 years. But just I'm nothing for any comparison to him. Bismillah.
والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قل وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى.
طبعا just one word, if I have 1 second long breath, I would bring it. Alhamdulillah. That's Sheikh Abdul Basit. طيب. جزاكم الله خير. طيب. Any other question? Inshallah. Go ahead, brother. عليكم السلام. Yes. And not all of them, but all of them recite by maqamat, but not all of them, they are switching. I taught two of them. Two of them, they are switching because I did this with them. Other imams, they also switch, but not like, I don't like to mention names, يعني, because if now we are live. But two of Imams al-Haram, even Sheikh Hatim saw one of them. I showed you the video. Yeah, he switches a lot. It was like Maqam al-Banjaka, even the details, like the small branchy maqams. Yeah, that's Imams al-Haram. فإمام الحرم do that. Minshawi, Abdul Basit, Mustafa Ismail, Husari, Muhammad Rib, they do that. Okay, which one doesn't recite by maqamat? Give me one qari. Does it recite by maqamat? No way. No one. That means 1000% the Prophet was reciting with it. Otherwise, we have problem in the tawatur, al-iyadh billah. Okay, Sheikh. Last question, inshallah, from men's side and women's side. Start with women. If you have any question here. Okay, men's side, do you have any question? Go ahead, brother. Bismillah. عليكم السلام. Originally from, that's علماء الصوت, the scientist of voice. They categorize the voices and they named it. Okay, maybe 700 years ago, they did this and they named it. Before they were calling it التحزين, التفريح. يعني الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى. الإمام ابن القيم passed away like more than 800 years. Okay, there is no that time Sika Saba Nahawand. That's the just new names. Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, said, وَمَنْ يَعْلَمْ أَحْوَالِ السَّلَفِ فِي تِلَاوَةِ الْقُرْآنِ يَتَأَكَّدْ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَقْرَؤُونَ بِالتَّحْزِينِ تَارَ وَبِالْفَرَحِ تَارَ وَبِالْحَمَاسَةِ تَارَ وَبِالتَّأْثِيرِ وَالْخُشُوعِ تَارَ. The Sheikh ibn al-Qayyim, the great imam, عالم كبير. He said that if you wanted to know how the Salaf was reciting, they were reciting with sad way one time. Another time they were reciting with happy, otherwise with excited one. He doesn't say maqam because there is no word of maqam at that time. And he doesn't say Sika and Nahawand and Saba because these names, it's like new names. But like what I said, also the word of Ghunna, the word of Mad, it wasn't exist in the time of Rasulullah. Who did it? علماء التجويد. To categorize the science, to make it easy for people. In the time of Rasulullah, there is no hadith sahih, hadith hasan, hadith ضعيف. علماء الحديث, رحمهم الله تعالى وغفر لهم, they categorize the hadith with these new names to make it easy for people, those who comes after hundreds of years of the time of Rasulullah. You understand me? شروط صحة الصلاة, مستحبات الصلاة, مكروهات الصلاة, the conditions of all these things, the Prophet did not talk about it. The fuqaha talk about it. Why? To make it easy for people to understand how the Prophet was dealing with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You understand me? جزاكم الله خيرا, my brothers and sisters. بارك الله فيكم. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us with al-habib al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say ameen. اللهم بارك لإخواننا في مسجدهم. اللهم بارك في هذا المسجد المبارك يا رب العالمين. اللهم بارك لهم في هذا المسجد المبارك يا رب العالمين. اللهم افتح عليهم من الرزق فتحا. اللهم صب عليهم من نعائمك صبا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل هذا المجلس المبارك مجلسا خالصا لوجهك الكريم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ما حدث فيه من زلل أو خطأ، وتقبل منا ما حدث فيه من صواب برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظ إخواننا وأخواتنا في هذا المسجد المبارك، احفظهم بحفظك الذي لا يرام، اكلأهم بعينك التي لا تنام، رد عنهم كيد الكائدين وحسد الحاسدين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظ الذريات، اللهم احفظ ذرياتنا، اللهم احفظ أطفالنا، اللهم احفظ أبناءنا، اللهم احفظ بناتنا يا رب العالمين بحفظك الكريم. اللهم اجعلهم ينشؤون في طاعتك يا أحكم الحاكمين. اللهم اجعلهم ينشؤون ويكون القرآن ربيع قلوبهم. اللهم اجعل القرآن ربيع قلوبنا. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم جلاء لهمومنا وأحزاننا. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم شفاء لأسقامنا وأمراضنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن قلت فيهم وممن قال نبيك فيهم الماهر بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام البررة. اللهم اجعلنا من السفرة الكرام البررة. اللهم اجمعنا مع السفرة الكرام البررة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.